My senior year of high school, I was in a car accident, and I was wearing my seatbelt, and my boyfriend wasn't. And, I mean, we were both okay, but his hand went through the windshield, and if he had been wearing a seatbelt, he probably would have had to stop himself with his hand. And since I was wearing a seatbelt, I didn't go through the windshield into a tree, so they're really important to me.
Yeah, I don't want to die.
I think teens and young adults tend to think that they're bulletproof, and you know, my son was 30 when he was killed in an automobile accident, a rollover accident. He did have a seatbelt on. He was a deputy sheriff, and he knew the importance of wearing a seatbelt. So that's why I say it's not a guarantee, but it certainly improves your likelihood of survival in an accident.
Yeah, I do know a lot of people who don't make it a point to wear a seatbelt when they get in the car, so that actually does make a lot of sense.
I can imagine, and especially like in activities, a lot of people probably don't want to wear their seatbelts when going out and stuff, so that doesn't surprise me in the slightest.
Yes.
How do you feel about that?
Fair loss.
Can you repeat the question?
What do you mean?
That's a weird question to answer.
I guess just like learning about everybody's health and just trying to take care of it as best as you can.
I guess just like safety and wellness for like the general public, I don't know.
Public health to me is the health of the public.
I guess we could be saving lives by like promoting seatbelt wearing, I guess, or seatbelt awareness.
If people get in wrecks and they're wearing seatbelts, they're more likely to not be injured, so they'll be healthier.
I think the quality of your life would be more improved, and it would probably be longer if you wore a seatbelt.
People being dumb. I mean, yeah. It's just kind of your choice. You probably should wear a seatbelt, but if you don't, then you know, you gotta accept the consequences that occur from doing that. So that's really a personal choice.
Because a lot of people feel that the seatbelt law is stupid and that like the government doesn't have a right to tell them that they have to wear a seatbelt. So I'm not surprised that people still don't wear their seatbelts.
Probably, I know like my best friend's mom, when we get in a car, like, she's kind of big, so she's not comfortable wearing her seatbelt, so she never wears it.
I think it can. It probably saved mine.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
I definitely think it's a good thing to make seatbelt wearing a law, because I feel like people just, they don't feel like wearing seatbelts, so they don't, because people don't really enforce it as much as they should.
My dad, when he was in college, went through the windshield after getting a car accident.
Is he still alive?
Yes. He's alive and well.
I feel like a statistic that could be easily changed, just 2 extra seconds of clicking a buckle.
Is public health. Public health is collectively all the things that we as a society do to try to improve the health of the population, it is both a matter of individual personal behavior and government policy at all levels, local, federal, even institutional, like Clemson. When Clemson decides to change its coal-fired electrical plant to some other fuel source that improves air quality and in the long run may prevent some cases of emphysema or lung cancer or something down the road. And it's really, you know, one of the unique things about public health is that everyone either contributes to the problem or contributes to the solution, but no one person can be the problem or be the solution. So we all have to kind of pitch in and try to work together to improve the health of the population.
You know, I feel like going back to my island now.